In this video, we are going to explain how to use one of the NCS modules. It's called static structure to do the simulations for hip implants. To start a simulation, we need actually create a project. To create a project, we need to double click this static structure. You'll see a new project is created in this working area. In this new project, we have a title, we have a engineering data, then a geometry, we have a model itself, and assign the setup, assign the boundary conditions, and then we can solve the simulation. Then eventually we can view the results. So we just go through this step by step to do our simulation. So the first step is to get the engineering data. If you click on this engineering data, you'll see the ANSYS system gives you a default material, which is structural steel. It's been commonly used for engineering, but for us, for medical application, we may need stainless steel, we may need titanium. But in this case, we need to go to engineering data source to find out whether there's a titanium already been used by the software. If not, we have to create our own material properties. Let's click on this one. You'll see there's a one more window appears, and it is called outline of general material. If you scroll this bar up and down, you'll see that we have air, aluminium, we have copper, and the end of this list, we have this titanium. If not, we have to actually add our own material property in. So if we have this titanium alloy, and click on the plus sign to add this one into the material property. Once this property is added in, we can just click this again. Then you'll see both structural steel and the titanium alloy in the outline of the engineering data. In our case, we don't need structural material, so we only need titanium alloy. So what we have to do, we right click on this one, then we click on delete, then we only have this titanium material only. So now the material has been assigned to the project. Then we can move to the next step. If we just click on this cross, then that tick appears. So the next step would be the geometry, which will be explained in the next video.